Hong Kong International Airport is the main airport in Hong Kong and operates 24 hours a day. Flights are operated by about 90 airlines to 150 cities across the globe. In 2009, it was the 13th busiest airport worldwide in terms of passengers. And in 2010, the airport became the busiest airport in terms of cargo traffic in the world, passing Memphis Airport in the United States.
Hong Kong Island is dominated by steep hilly terrain, which required the development of unusual methods of transport up and down the slopes. The mid-level escalator is the longest outdoor covered escalator system in the world, operating downhill until 10 a.m. for commuters going to work and then operating uphill until midnight. It is 800 meters long and climbs 135 vertical meters. Daily traffic exceeds 35,000 people. It has been operating since 1993 and cost 240 million Hong Kong dollars to build.
There are altogether 10 lines in the Hong Kong rail system with a total of 83 railway stations and 68 light rail stops. The rail systems are operated by MTR Corporation Limited, and all rails are very efficient and incredibly clean. The Peak Tramway in Hong Kong carries both tourists and residents to the upper levels of Hong Kong Island and provides awesome views over the harbor and skyscrapers in Hong Kong. The Peak Tram's route from Central District to Victoria Peak covers a distance of 1 mile and a height difference of just under 1,500 feet. In 1881, Alexander Smith put the project of the Peak Railway into shape. It took 3 years to build the Peak Tram, as much of the heavy equipment and rails had to be hauled uphill by workers who had no mechanical support. In May of 1888, the Peak Tram was opened for public service, and at the time it used a static steam engine to power the haulage cable. The system was comprehensively rebuilt in 1989 by Swiss company Von Roy. Today, more than 4 million people ride the Peak Tram annually, or an average of over 11,000 every day.
According to Hong Kong, there are 584,000 licensed vehicles in Hong Kong and about 2,050 kilometers of public roads. Most cars in Hong Kong are right-hand drive, and surprisingly, left-hand drive models are not allowed. The ferry ride from Hong Kong to Macau is a one-hour ride, and the ferry runs 24/7. Usually every half hour, and is relatively cheap at $15. However, remember you must travel with a passport since you're leaving Hong Kong, which is considered to be a special territory of China. The one strange thing that we found is that you could use Hong Kong money in Macau, but you couldn't use Macau money in Hong Kong. The ferry ride that took place in Victoria Harbor was one of the nicest ways to spend our evening, since we got to see one of the largest light shows in the world put on a regular basis every night. It was a 1.5 hour cruise and cost approximately $1 million per night to run the show.
Shanghai Pudong International Airport is a fast-growing hub for both passenger and cargo traffic. With 3.2 million metric tons handled in 2010, the airport is the third busiest airport in the world in terms of freight travel. Pudong Airport has also served a total of 40.6 million passengers in 2010, making it the third busiest airport in mainland China and the 20th busiest in the world. Passenger and cargo traffic both grew by more than 27% in 2010 at the airport.
The Shanghai Maglev train, the first commercial Maglev railway in the world, was constructed in cooperation with Germany, and the route runs from Shanghai's Longyang Road subway station in Pudong to Pudong International Airport. Commercial operation started in 2003. The 30-kilometer track takes 7 minutes and 21 seconds and reaches a maximum speed of 431 kilometers per hour or 270 miles per hour. Normal operating speeds usually hover around that area, but during a test run, the Maglev was shown to reach a top speed of over 500 kilometers per hour.
The Shanghai Metro Rapid Transit System has 12 lines and extends to every core urban district in Shanghai. According to the development schedule, by the year 2012, another two lines will be built. It is one of the fastest growing systems in the world, and its first line just opened in 1995. From Shanghai to Beijing, we took the overnight train, which lasted 9 hours in time. The train departed at 10 o'clock at night and arrived in Beijing at 7 o'clock in the morning. In July of 2011, China is now opening a new rail system between these two cities, which will drop the time from 9 hours to 4 hours. The sleeping cars were actually quite comfortable, and they consisted of 4 beds to 1 cart.
The Chinese began using a rickshaw in China during the late 19th century, and it was originally made from bamboo for the social elite. It was estimated that in the early 1900s, 1 in 6 males between the age of 16 to 50 was a puller of a rickshaw. Recently, the original rickshaw was pulled by a man, which has now been replaced with bicycles because it is seen as a symbol of oppression, pulling by hand. The word rickshaw comes from a Japanese word, rick meaning force and shaw meaning vehicle.
Beijing as of 2011 has an estimated 5 million registered cars on its roads, so traffic congestion is widespread. It is predicted by 2012, Beijing will have over 6 million cars on its roads. To combat congestion, the local government has rapidly been building the subway system and adding more lines and working towards doubling the length of the subway system by 2015. In 2008, Beijing introduced restrictions on the amount of cars on its roads in an attempt to reduce congestion and pollution during the Olympic Games. They did this by adopting odd-even traffic restriction on alternate days. Cars with the number plates ending with odd numbers were restricted one day, and the next day, cars with the numbers ending with even numbers were restricted. Similar methods have been used today to where a citizen has one day a week where they are restricted.
Make sure when you arrive at the Great Wall to walk up and take a 30 to 40 minute hike, as it makes the ride down with toboggans that much greater. The toboggans have become quite popular, spanning much of the stations along the Great Wall, and resulted in quite a few injuries, one in our group due to speeds reaching up to 30 miles an hour.
Shake that. on the block. With a drink, I got to know. Top jeans tattoo, cause I'm rockin' wrong. Half black, half white, diamond low. Gang of money, open door.
Yeah, I'm running through these halls like Drano. I got that devilish flow. Rock and roll, no halo. We pour.